Good afternoon to one and all. I am Amol Puri, Head Publications and Documentations at IEEE Student Branch of Bharatiya Vidyapeeth College of Engineering. Welcome you all to the second session of our flagship event, Innovicon 2.0 Track 1 Higher Education. Today's session will throw light on how to ace Common Admission Test Examination. CAT is a computer-based test for admission in a graduate management program. Right now, all the CAT examination aspirants must be confused regarding the exam or how will opportunities change for them post-COVID-19. To answer all your queries and guide you on how to ace the exam, we have a very experienced mentor amongst us for the session, Mr. R. Srinivas from Career Launcher. Mr. Srinivas is the National Head of MBA Preparation, India and Abroad at Career Launcher Educate. He is a legendary teacher and a great motivator who has mentored thousands of students to success. It's an honor for team BVP IEEE to have a speaker of such great repute for our session. Now I request sir to please proceed with this session.
Thank you so much, Amol. Thanks for inviting me for this session. I'm going to take up this entire thing in two parts, my friends. One, of course, is to look at why, given that you guys are from BVP, why even look at management as a career? What makes really the career or careers in management everlasting, if I may want to call that word? But the second part of that will be also on why and how to look at the IIMs, some of the top institutes in the country, and whether it is really easy to get into the IIMs and other institutes, or is it real that they say that this exam is really, really tough? So that is going to be my overall presentation over the next 35, 40 minutes. And post which, please feel free to ask any questions that you have. I will try my level best to kind of incorporate some of the FAQs, if I can call it, that you might have in your own minds if you go through this session. Okay, so let's start with a very, very basic agenda. I'm going to talk about certain career options. You'll be surprised to know that MBA is not just about MBA in India, but there are so many options available abroad too, whether it's the MIM program in Europe. A lot of new programs have come up, or for that matter, a deferred MBA program. Even when you are in the final year of college, the chance to apply to the Harvards, the Stanfords, the Yales of the world. So we'll talk about those two things also. And at the end of it, I'm going to discuss about what makes really this preparation either easy or very difficult. But as I said, let me start with looking at some of the problems that each one of us have. Do you, when we do our graduation, the UG as we call it in various places, whether it is engineering or those of us who are not engineers also, because it's going live on FB and YouTube, I want to kind of not mention it only engineers, but you know, there is a lot of doubt in their minds as to saying that why even I am doing an engineering, or why am I doing a BCom or a BSc or a BTech, BA for that matter. Many a time, you take a decision based on the 9th, 10th class scores that you probably have, or more often than not, is because of an uncle or an aunt or a mother or a father who has kind of pushed you into taking up what you didn't want to take up in the first place. When I'm saying this, trust me, you know, when we take up engineering, we don't even know why we are doing it. In a career spanning 35, 40 years, it's not a crime to do a wrong thing at your initial levels. Do not worry about that. And there are too many choices available. And that's where probably an MBA comes into. I would look at it that way, as a help as such. Okay. Now let's talk about how in India, especially in India, we take decisions of career. Very interestingly, we first write an exam. It could be an IIT JEE. It could be an entrance examination like an IPMAT or a CLAT or anything else. Depending on what scores you get, you will get a college. And depending on that college, you get a course. And finally, unfortunately, you have to live with this career as you go along. Is that even the right way? Frankly, I don't know how many of you have looked at the National Education Policy 2020. Frankly, certain things of this are being addressed in the 9th to 12th class levels. The right way would be, can I choose the kind of a career that I'm looking at? And depending on what kind of a career, it could be management, it could be a technical career for that matter, it could be civil services tomorrow for that matter. But depending on that career, you choose the course that you will choose in your UG or PG, and then, you know, the pecking order of the college becomes obvious. Once you know all these three things, you know the entry to that might be having through an exam or a score in your score, like 10th, 12th, or whatever else that you have, or the eligibility criteria. If any one of us has not done this, like choosing a career as such, looking at a career as such, I think it is important. It is very, very important that even now, when you are in your graduation, whatever graduation you're doing, if it is engineering, even more so, you take the right decision right now. Like we said, this is careers in management or the opportunities in management that I want to look at it. Let me tell you something very interesting. Look at what are the options available today. If you go to Glassdoor, you will find the top 15 jobs that are available in the world, not just in India. As you can see, certain things like mobile developer, front-end engineer, a data scientist, these were not there 10 years, 12 years back. Today, they have become very, very important. But notice something else. Notice HR manager, marketing, finance manager, business development manager, a risk manager, a product manager. These were there 20 years back. These are there today. And very, very likely that these will continue to exist the next 30 years too. And why is that? The reason is very simple. The way of doing business might have changed. COVID has put you back in your room, in your homes, but you're still buying through an Amazon or a Flipkart or a Big Basket. Why is that? And that's simply because the route of buying or selling has changed. The medium has changed. You still need a marketing manager or a business deal manager or a finance manager for that matter, or HR manager to take care of the people. So the business-oriented requirement or business-oriented jobs that are there will continue to exist even if the entire way of doing business has changed. And that is the reason why you can clearly see 7 out of the 15 top jobs in the world today, the gateway to those is an MBA. And that is where, when people look at it seriously, when people look at taking a career in management, they look at getting away from engineering. They kind of don't like their jobs. They kind of looking at saying that it's an easier way to get a salary, growth, etc., which may be true, by the way. None of them are wrong. But what is much, much more important, and that is what, to my mind, you need to try, is why you're doing it. And when, especially, this is something which is obvious, and if you really look at if you look at all the history of the last maybe 1,000 years, definitely the last 100 years, even if you want to be a great technical guy, trust me, the best of technology or the best of innovations, you do it before you are 30 years old. What do you do post that? That is where experience, that is where growth, that is where understanding of the world comes into picture and understanding of the business comes into picture. So sooner or later, you need to reach there. So therefore, my consideration and my endeavor has been, why not the same right now if you are up to it, if you have the aspiration for it, if you have the ambition for it? I think when you are in graduation, when you are doing your graduation, that is the time when you start preparing. And this is not a difficult exam, because this is one exam which we'll talk about in a little while from today. is available for anybody and everybody. But prior to that, let me look at why an MBA as a career makes sense. I have put in three reasons for this. There are many reasons, but three obvious reasons. The first one is, of course, salaries. Everybody talks about salaries. Let me tell you something very, very upfront on this. It is not just the IIMs which will give you good salaries. It is not just the XLRIs or the FMSs which will give you good salaries. The top 50 business schools in India, the average salaries in the top 50 business schools in India is upwards of 10 lakhs per annum. Some of them I'm going to showcase to you in today's presentation itself. So when you start, the platform at which you start is going to be very, very important. Then the next comes in the growth itself. Okay, I start well. Where do I go from here? And that is the beauty of it. In fact, if there is one background or one degree that you can have, which will continue to kind of give you the kind of growth that is required consistently over a period of time, and that is an MBA degree. Even if it is from the 50th ranked college, forget about the top. And the compounded annual growth rate, CAGR as we call it, find out, look upon what is CAGR, is more than 15% year on year. And that is what makes this even more lucrative. But trust me, you know, the third reason I'm going to give you, apart from how the progression happens and what is the real flexibility, is the possible reason why each one of us has to look at this very, very seriously. Most of us have zero clue, as I said in the very beginning, of why and what do you want to be? You know, do you really know your calling? If, when I was doing my engineering, if somebody told me that I would be the national head for an MBA education company, I would have laughed at them because I was extremely interested in some computer science. In fact, the first, in my final year, my project that I did was a speech synthesizer. Today, what people talk about Alexa and Siri, 27 years back, the phonetics of that, I started it. Maybe I would have been a billionaire if I had continued. Maybe I was not interested, or it was bad luck, maybe. But the fact of the matter is, even if I knew what to do, if I did not know how to sell, it would have been waste. The flexibility to do what I wanted to do. I worked with Maruti Udyog Limited, Maruti Suzuki, selling cars for 3 years. How do you shift that to a pharmaceutical company, which I did, and then to an education? This ability to, you know, showcase the flexibility is what makes MBA really, really worth its while. And the key thing, and if you don't want that flexibility, if you want to be in the normal corporate job too, I said the second part, the growth, is a very consistent growth. Let's look at this. What is the great career progression we talk about advantage doing an MBA? It's because when you graduate in, let's say, 24, 25, after doing an MBA in any of the marketing, finance, HR, operation systems areas, in the initial stages, you spend time on being a junior manager. You will be picking up a functional role. But soon enough, you take up the middle management role. In fact, if you are a technologist, if you are only in the technical side, nobody is going to give you cross-functional experience. Nobody is going to give you new choices as such. But if you are an MBA, it's almost a guarantee that you might be a marketing head. Sooner or later, they will help you to work on finance areas or HR areas, not for a too long a time, but for 4 or 5 years, so that they groom you. They groom you towards higher levels of management. And that is where you get into senior management, where again you become a head of a functional or a division in your 35 to 40, 45 years. Depending on how well you do, how enterprising you are, how risk taker you are, you probably become a CXO and grow up the ladder, maybe go into a CEO levels too. But this career progression, is very, very structured in large organizations. If you are going to do a startup, maybe you will start up with, because if you are the five people in a startup on your own, maybe you will become a CXO tomorrow morning. But if you want to really showcase or rather handle thousands of crores of business, I think a steady progress is very, very important. You learn as you go out. I do understand a lot of people today, a lot of kids today, a lot of students today, the generation X, Y, millennials as such, are very, very impatient to grow. If you work for a same thing for 6 months, you feel, oh boy, what am I doing again and again? But if you look at all people who have been successful, the success has come because of consistency. And that consistency is what you will get in large organizations. Maybe it will not be very exciting, but you can take up that exciting part depending on who you are. But the second reason, advantage two, I told you about flexibility, the versatility to shift games, shift things. I want to give you an example of two of my classmates way back in 1997. I have graduated from IIM Calcutta in 1997. So I had two brilliant friends, classmates of mine. In fact, there were many of them. I'm just giving you two examples. Interestingly, you will find that one guy, Prashant, is a BE in computer science. Like I have chosen my path, this guy, his immediately after his MBA itself, chosen an FMCG path. He worked with Hindustan Unilever for a very long time. And today he's the managing director at Mondelez, which is nothing but Cadbury's. A computer science guy, mind you, heading a chocolate company, if you can understand that. And chocolate, of course, and they have other beverages too. Then, how does this come in with another person, Kamolika Gupta? Think about it. She is a BA in economics from Presidency College, Calcutta. BA in economics. In the wild dreams also, nobody would have believed when she was doing her BA in economics. Of course, Google would have started at that point of time, just about in 99, but nobody would have known that she would be the Google Cloud Director 23 years after graduating. BA in economics, mind you. And look at Prashant, BE in computer science. I should have written there, BE in computer science from KJ Somaiya College of Engineering in Mumbai. That is versatility. That is flexibility. That is the freedom that one gets to look at an MBA. I'm not saying MBA is the only thing that you can do. The idea here is if you have that background, you don't know what you are good at. Most of us don't. And therefore, I think it is extremely important that you keep that freedom away. You have the freedom for you to choose what you want, maybe at 22 years age, maybe at 32 years age. At 32, you want to change your life, change your career. How do you do that without any background? Here is the name of the guy who has done that. I don't know how many of you know him. His name is Amish Tripathi. Amish has written some blockbuster sellers, The Immortals of Meluha, The Nagas, The Vayuputras, The Trilogy of Shiva, or the Trilogy of the Ramayana, The Ram, The Sita and Ravan. The latest book he has released is Suhail Dev. Each one of these has sold lots and lots of copies. Guess what? This guy is a BCom from St. Xavier's, Bombay. He is my classmate too. And I am Calcutta classmate of 1997. Not just classmate. Incidentally, I keep using his name all the time because it's, of course, a proud moment. He is not just a classmate, but also a wingmate. And I don't think we would have ever thought about it, that this gentleman is going to become a greatest writer just 20 years after he finished his graduation or post-graduation from IIM Calcutta. The ability to choose, even after 8-9 years of working in a corporate एंड कंप्लीटली कोई हटके करना, यू नो यू नीड टू हैव द गट्स, मोर देन दैट यू नीड टू हैव द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डू दैट, एंड दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी इज व्हाट वी टॉक अबाउट व्हेन वी डिस्कस एन एमबीए. When somebody says, hey, are there opportunities in MBA, in a management career? Oh, there are tons of them, provided you have the patience and the a little bit of a smartness to explore that. And these three people are my classmates. I don't think it is good to showcase or not showcase Mr. Chetan Bhagat. Chetan is also a batchmate of my 1997 batch of IIM Ahmedabad that year. I'm from Calcutta, he's from Ahmedabad. Again, one of the most successful authors and now a very big public figure. He's an IITian, he's an engineer from IIT Delhi, worked in a finance company for a few years and then took the plunge. It was not easy. It is just not easy. But he has done that. And there are tons of people who have taken up various kinds of things. I'm not going to get into that. But there are three things that we talk about that if you want to be a manager, if you want to get into management, especially from the top institutes, if you are from the absolute from the top institutes, you will have the chance to look at it. The first one is a normal corporate job where you can keep consistently growing. Of course, you need to perform, but consistently growing much more than any non-MBA. The second is very clearly either you are an entrepreneur yourself or a person who starts a startup, you will be given more opportunities at the very beginning itself to, for you to grow. It doesn't matter what your background is to a large extent because you are given everything. And the third one is a hatke, different kind of a background. You can get into sports management, you can go into writing, you can go into painting, you can go into films, direction, advertising, doesn't matter which one, provided you are interested. Event management, another one, you can get into that. I think that ability and the opportunities, you know, despite COVID, yes, some people will lose jobs. Yes, some people will have deferred joinings, but they will need business people. All the more reason I will need better business people the moment this COVID thing gets over. Maybe 1 month, maybe 2 months, maybe 6 months. It doesn't matter. But it will require, I told you, MBA towards the kind of a gateway required. How do I improve my business given that the entire world has changed? How do I make sure that my marketing, you know, I used to spend money on newspaper, Times of India or the TV. Now it is on an Instagram. I used to do it in Facebook, but less of Facebook, more of Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, you name it. And there are new ways in which we are looking at advertising. Advertising has not changed. The medium of advertising has changed. The basics of marketing has not changed. And that is what makes it really, really evergreen for you. The other important thing, given the fact that, yes, MBA as a career is a great idea, it is important to realize that what are the things available for you? It's good enough to do an MBA, but can you do anywhere else? There are 3,000 business schools in the country. Frankly, especially some of you, or those of you who are listening to me from BVP and from the top schools, even if you are from not so top schools, aim for the very best. MBA in India, the IIMs, plus 13 other IIMs, ABCLIK and 13 other IIMs, FMS, XLRI, Jamnalal Bajaj, SPJN, MDI, IFT, NMIMS, SIBM, and a lot of others, of course. They will expect you to write an exam called CAT. You will need a very good score in 10th and 12th, very high score if required be, but a bare minimum of 95 percentile if you want to go to the top 20 institutes, top 25 institutes. If you need to get into an ABC, you will probably need a 99.7. I'm going to talk about what is this 99.7 a little while later. Is MBA in India better? Or should I look at MBA abroad? It is not abroad or India that matters. It is which college that you do. If you go to a Harvard or a Yale or a Stanford or a Wharton or a NY Stern, makes sense to go to a foreign institute. But if you're talking about a 100th ranked institute in US versus a 50th ranked institute in India, for the return on investment, it just might be better off to do finish off in India itself. Interestingly, if you are in the final year or if you are not graduated, you can apply to the best of the institutes through a route called the deferred MBA route, where you get an admission. When you get an admission by writing GMAT and application and applying to this, including our own ISB, Indian School of Business in Hyderabad and Mohali, they have this thing called the Young Leaders Program. You get a chance to join them 2 years later after your graduation. So you get an admit when you are in the final year. But after that, you are told, hey, listen, this is your admission. Now work for 2 years and come back to us. Or you'd be surprised, a lot of this European business schools, a lot of European business schools are giving you masters in management abroad, equivalent to an MBA. Yes, a shade less, simply because it is for people with less than 2 years of experience. People with more than 5 years experience do an MBA abroad. Typically, of course, India does not have that kind of a restriction. In India, you can be a fresher, you can be with less than 1 year experience, or you can be a 5+ years experience. You can still do a 2 year MBA. There is no age restriction on that, nor a mandatory work experience required. And this is something which I think each one of you have to go back to, you know, any business school's portal and check it out. I am Ahmedabad. Go to the placement portal and check the criteria or the people who are there and how many people are freshers. You will find more than 50% are less than 11 months of experience. 35% are full freshers. Such kind of people in India, Pakistan, China, etc. If they want to go out, there were not too many avenues 10 years back. Today, University of St. Gallen, HEC, IE Business School, ISEC, ESSEC, all of these have come back. And again, what do you need? You need a good profile. I'll talk about what the profile in the next slide. You need to have good and consistent academics, all right, but you need to have also a good extracurricular and curricular profile to showcase to you. Profile is not just internships. It is a part of it. Profile is not just NGO work or projects. It's a part of it, which kinds of showcases certain aspects of your personality. What are these? Let's look at this. A profile looks at, apart from your 10th and 12th scores. In fact, in general, I ask this question in my sessions. How many of you have more than 90% in 10th and 12th? You'll be surprised. And every time I asked, a lot of people have that. How do you differentiate a person with 90 plus and 89 plus? 89 kind of things. Hardly any differentiation. Yes, some criteria has to be there. Therefore, they do it. But it is important to note that apart from scores, apart from your 10th and 12th and degree scores, which are important partially in your profile, you need to add leadership, initiative, innovation. Can you think about how do I get this? For example, Google Meet is what we are working on, this through which it is, you know, beamed onto a YouTube or a Facebook Live with zero cost. Think about it. That's innovation. I'm sure you learned from somewhere, but that's innovation instead of spending a lot of money on a WebEx or a Zoom. Having said that, can you negotiate? Can you negotiate with Zoom saying that, hey, I'm a BVP, give me free for these sessions so that I will say thank you to Zoom every time I do a session? That's smartness. That's quantitative and initiative impact. Can you show in your CV consistent such efforts where you have said that you have built up? How do you show that? So what are the things that you can show in your profile development? Apart from extracurricular activities like the dance, music, painting, skits, don't worry about the last 4-5 months what has gone down. Maybe the next 3 months will go down the drain. 2020, write it off. But your life is not 2020. How many of you remember what happened in 2013 in your life? 2013 in your life, 7 years back. 7 years back, some of you were in the 6th class, 7th class, 8th class maybe. Do you really remember anything except for one or two incidents? So is it, you will not remember what has happened 4 months back itself. Every day is going. In fact, we went into lockdown on March 22nd, 23rd, 24th, whatever. And we are talking about August 11th today. Look at it. We have just lived with this. You will forget a lot of things that you have done. Some of you might have used this very, very nicely. Some of you, it have been frustrating for you. That's okay, guys. Can you now do something about it? Pick up some projects, pick up some research publications, pick up some social work for that matter, for taking care of the COVID patients and or COVID affected daily wage earners. Can you do something on that side? Be improve sustainability for some of them. Beti Bachao is a still important thing. Can you teach somebody? You know, boss, there is no dearth of choices that you have if only you just get out of your homes, or even at homes, get out of your Netflixes and the Hotstars and whatever not that you have. You can do that. And that is what I would say. Mix you getting into an MBA that much more easier. So let's look at what are the top schools. And I'm going to very, very quickly look at it. And maybe in the next 15 minutes, I will end this so that, you know, I can answer a lot of very specific questions that some of you may probably have. Okay. So what are the top schools that you have which gives you a good return on investment? You talk about that's my alma mater. I am Ahmedabad. I am Bangalore. I am SPJ in Mumbai, FMS, XLRI. A lot of institutes have more than 22 lakhs per annum average salaries. All of them have more than 100% ROI, the return on investment in 2 years. Can you see that? Can you see that? And the next question comes in. Sir, ye toh sab bahut acha hai. Aapne toh bol diya ki kar sakte ho. But how do you get there? I'll answer that question also. But I'll give you one information here. Most of you who probably are listening to this are technical guys, engineers probably. Here is what I'm going to tell you about a BCom student of mine. Just listen to this for 2 minutes. Two guys I'm going to talk about so that I will make it really real anecdotal, because you know, guys, a lot of people don't try to get into an MBA or to the IIMs or any of the best institutes because they think it is not for them or they think it is difficult. So I'm going to talk about two people, and post that I'm going to, you know, rush through kind of things, and then we will take up questions and answers. Anybody and everybody can do an MBA is my premise for this. Now, this is about a student. His name is Tej Vangaviti. Tej was a BCom. You know, one of these sessions, of course, not today, a long time back, about 15, 17 years back, I was taking a session, something, obviously not this, but a similar kind of a session, why I was telling that, look, you need to do an MBA. He heard me out. He said, boss, ye toh achha dikh raha hai, become. But then he asked me one question. Sir, I have a question for you. His question was, sir, I have 58% in my BCom. Sir, I have only 58% in my BCom, 55% in my 12th, and actually, sir, I have only 52% in my 10th class, 10th standard. You know, all of you would have 80 plus, most of you at least. This guy coming to me and saying, sir, I have 52% in 10th, 55% in 12th, and 58% in 10th, 55 in 12th, and 52 in BCom. My mistake. It's the reverse. 58 in 10th, 55 in 12th, and 52 in BCom. It's like going down. Tomorrow you're going to fail. But he said, sir, do you think, listen to this statement. He said, sir, and he didn't have any work experience. His question was, listen carefully. His question was, sir, do you think I can get into IIM Ahmedabad? I immediately said no. Listen to this once again. His question was, sir, do you think I can get into IIM Ahmedabad? My answer was, no. But do you? When I asked this question, he was blinking at me. His question was, sir, do you think I can get into IIM Ahmedabad? My question was, no, but do you? How does it matter if ARCS thinks or does not think whether you can get into IIM Ahmedabad? It is you, my friend, who has to think. If you think, you may get into IIM Ahmedabad. If you don't think, you will not get into an IIM Ahmedabad. That's the purport of that statement. He got up, thanked me. Of course, he joined me in my CAT program. And as they say, the rest is history. He did get into IIM Ahmedabad that year. He is now in New York, in JP Morgan Chase, in a very, very good financial position, earning $500,000. Today, it is not easy to get into IIM Ahmedabad with 52% BCom, by the way, because they have a minimum requirement in 10th and 12th also. Not really 10th and 12th, but degree, they have a minimum requirement of 75%, 73% to be precise. But it was possible. If not IIM Ahmedabad, it could be IIM Calcutta. If it's not IIM Calcutta, it could be somebody else. The beauty, my friends, is that there is a chance. It is not one institute. There are hundreds of institutes that you can think of. And you will be surprised. The other anecdote, a very small anecdote, I'm not going to spend too much of time on this because I said 45 minutes. Maybe I'll try to skip this maybe. But suffice it to say, this guy, this gentleman that I'm talking about, K.V.S. Chowdhury, again, a guy from Hyderabad and from Hyderabad, did not know a sentence in English when he came to me first. January is what I remember meeting him. December was CAT, or November end, or December was CAT. It was only what, 11 months, 10 months? Not only he made it to some IIMs and IRMA and other institutes, he could learn impeccable English with a little accent, of course. Like I have a part accent of being a South Indian. Everybody has this in one way or the other, but he made it without knowing vocabulary. You know, many a time people are afraid that, yaar, mera kya hoga kind of things. You know, people, 2 days back, I was talking to a student who said, sir, my marks are not improving, sir. Marks are not improving. Ye normal hai. Maine bola, beta, kya kiya tumne? Kya kya kiya? Sir, maine 6 mock likha, sir. Arre yaar, very good. Tumne 6 mock likha. 6 mocks you have written. Okay. After writing the mock, what did you do? Sir, nothing, sir. I was feeling depressed. Okay. What did you do? Sir, I thought next mock, if I write, I will increase my marks. So I wrote the next mock. Arre, akal ke ande, only writing mocks, how will you improve? I'm sorry about it. I didn't use the word to that guy, but that's what I felt. Are you kidding me that you will write a mock after mock after mock and marks will improve? You know, that's what people say. You should write so many mocks. No, no. You can write mocks. You should write mocks. But somewhere between one mock and another mock, there has to be an improvement. Without basic improvement, if you are writing mock after mock after mock, you will get nothing beyond what you already know. So the idea here is to kind of utilize it. And there are opportunities. You don't want to miss these opportunities. These are the amazing amount of opportunities. 17 to 20 lakh schools, 15 to 17 lakh schools. This is like IITs, the SIBMs, the IIM Ranchis, all of them in the 15, 17 lakh range, 13 to 15 lakh range, even lower than IMT, IIM Trichy probably, Ranchi HR program, SCMHRD Pune, various, or even more institutes like IISc or IIM Ahmedabad's FABM program, but again, it's become much better. Shillong, it's also become 15 plus. You know that there are so many institutes. And then if you want to go MIM, I told you. University of St. Gallen, HEC, ESSEC Business School in France and Singapore. It gives you MSc in management, but brilliant, brilliant program. The weighted average is 90,000. The weighted salary is $90,000 close to. Very, very possible. MBA colleges in the world, too many choices available. First, your mind, you need to be clear that you want to get there. And once you know that you can get there, the process is very clear. If you notice, what I did very, very simply is two parts. The first part is to tell you, hey, friends, there are great career options, why you should choose an MBA. Second, where and how you can choose an MBA. The third one is getting into that top schools. What are the entrance process? The entrance processes in Indian B schools is the first shortlist is based on the CAT, ZAT and other scores and the profile score. And the final admission is based on your personal interview, the WAT and the GED score. And the profile score includes your 10th, 12th and degree work experience if you have, surely, but if you have certain diversity. In fact, this is diversity is in two ways. One is if you are a girl. All the girls who are listening to me, I think it's the best time to be a girl. And if you are also a non-engineer, actually, it's very good. But even otherwise, even if you are an engineer, trust me, go onto the websites and find out 80% of the students in the IIMs are engineers. Everybody says the general engineer males don't have a chance. Hey, are you kidding me? 40% of the students in the IIMs are gems, or rather 20% of the people are gems. That means to say you're getting there. You'll have to put in more fight. Similarly, when you look at the global B schools, you will have to showcase a wonderful profile, because that is what makes a real, real difference to your growth as such. Academics will be important, but not very. GRE, GMAT is a hygiene factor, very, very important too. What they took up is find out with the SOPs that you write, etc., why you want to do what you want to do. Not because everybody else is doing so. You need to have a clarity. And whatever clarity I've given you, you need to articulate it in a way where obviously the other guy says that this is not just a money-making kind of things, that reason why you're looking at it, but much more than that. And the final selection is basically a overall evaluation of your fitment and your future goals. In fact, this is something which we do majorly in Career Launcher in helping people to look at admission consulting also. And to get into all these institutes, the areas tested are very, very elementary, if I can use the word. Quantitative aptitude. Quant is of 8th, 9th and 10th standard. You might have forgotten it 4 years, 5 years, 6 years down the line. But if you can go back to your 8th, 9th and 10th classes, you will be able to comfortably make up for the lost time. Verbal ability. You know, it's not difficult, but it's not easy. I told you about if a student without a single sentence in English can make it in 10 months. You guys have been in English medium, 99% of you. Why can't you? That's because either you're lazy or not ready to putting in effort. Shed the laziness. Get that consistency up. You will get there. Logical reasoning and data interpretation. Nobody has taught you anything till now. It is common sense. Common sense can also improve with practice. Other areas, of course, come into. CAT gives you these four areas. ZAT gives you these areas. CET gives you these areas. SNAP gives you these areas. NMAT gives you these areas. IFT gives you this area. TISNIS gives you. MICAT gives you. All the exams in the world. All the exams in the world give you the same things. While I'm not saying it is enough if you only prepare for CAT, it is important that if you prepare for CAT, a lot of fundamentals which are required will be covered for every other exam. Yes, you need to orient yourself to that particular exam, if it is a GMAT or an NMAT or a SNAP, but the fundamentals remain the same. And this is where I would like to showcase to you why you can make it. Remember, if you are a gem also, you will need a 99.7 percentile. Remember, what is 99.7 percentile? Out of 300 marks, you need to get about 180. That is 60%, guys. 60% only. And if you have, look at this, 120, you get a 95%. If you remember what I showed you in one of the slides, to get into the newer IIMs and a lot of other top 25 calls, the colleges, you will need a 95 plus percentile. That's 120 out of 300. Sorry, 120 out of 300. That's 40%, 45%. Can you not make it? The point is, whether it is 3 months that you have or 15 months that you have, depending on when you're writing it, you have the chance to make it. Provided, I say this in C things, consistency, commitment to your life, and of course, confidence in yourself will make you get it. It's not rocket science. Lastly, it's 45 minutes I said I will take. I'll take another 3 minutes before I kind of welcome you to ask me a lot of questions, if there are any, of whether and when should you prepare and what should you prepare, etc. But I think, being from Career Launcher, which is 25 year old, we are celebrating on 14th of August, 25 years. I think it is important that we tell you who we are and why we have been successful. Our pedagogy ensures that you go through basic fundamentals. And once we go through, we don't assume anything at all. Then take you through applications and classes, and then look at mocks and testing. It has to be a systematic improvement through various interventions, whether they are funda book discussions, mock discussions, class sheet discussions, or smart cat cracker to make it very, very easy to do certain kind of questions. All these things is a part of our pedagogy and why we are far, far successful as we go along. The proof of the pudding, of course, is the eating. The reason why we are good is pedagogy, personalized preparation, probably the best academic team in the entire country among any other peers, mentoring by top faculty, and more importantly, the proof that we have got results. We have been there for 25 years, 25th year in our thing. We are not just into cat guys. We are into everything else. Student outreach, research, test preparation, of course, capacity building. We do faculty development programs. We have tie-ups with ISM Dhanbad, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Kanpur. We have Delhi government for education. And I think the industry academia interaction that we have a very, very holistic services that we provide to people. And that's what makes us, you know, we are the only listed company. We are not just a coaching institute. We are a listed company on the Bombay and the National Stock Exchanges. The people who are behind it are Satya, GP, Shivku, Sujit, Arks here given, Jijo, Srini, GB and Nikhil. All of them either from IIM Bangalore or Calcutta. There are so many other IIMs who are there. That's the reason I'm saying probably one of the best background teams that you can get, in fact, in the country itself. We are there in more than 200 centers in Delhi, of course. And we don't look at just MBA, GRE, GMAT, but locked up upskilling like FRM, NSC, business data, business analytics, data sciences, machine learning. You'll be surprised. We are there in all of these and more. As I said, the success is always on results. Whether it's GMAT, GRE, and MBA, we have been very, very successful almost all the last so many years. And how can we help you? Thank you for the BVP guys calling me today, but I'm just going to give you 1 minute again to showcase that. Look, we spend time in analyzing your profile too, to understand whether you want to do whatever you want to do, help you in the CAT, GRE, GMAT preparation, depending on where you want to go. Look at personality development, you know, improving yourself. And lastly, especially if it is a top business school in the world or a master school in the world, help you in SOP and letter of recommendations and admission counseling too. That's with that. Let me stop it here. I will call in Mr. Amol, who's there, who's introduced me very nicely. My name is Arks, A-R-K-S Srinivas. I'm an engineer in electronics and communication and an MBA from IIM Calcutta. The 23 years experience in the corporate and 20 in education. Feel free to ask. If I can stop sharing, Amol or Umang, if you are there, then we can take a few questions. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for such an amazing session. The session was really comprehensive and it has given birth to a lot of queries. Sir, we had recorded some queries prior to the session through the Google Forms too. So first we'll begin with those and then we'll move on to the queries that we have listed in the chat box.
Sure.
So yes, so sir, the first query that we have from one of our attendees is it better option to do job and then after 1 year of experience pursue for further studies?
So first and foremost, there is no such thing like 1 year job. 1 year, you hardly learn anything. That is the reason why if you look at across the world, if you look at especially an MBA, people, all the top class MBA institutes, I'm talking about the Harvards, the Stanfords, the London business schools of the world, or NCERTs, look at a minimum of 5 years of experience. So 1 year experience is of no use if you want to go to a top class MBA like the US or European business schools. Having said that, India as a culture now, and now Europe, which has recognized the Indian, Chinese and Southeast Asian countries, they allow you to do an MBA even immediately after your graduation. So there is no significant value except a few points that you get if you have a work experience. Not that because of work experience you will get it easily. It's as simple as the way I look at it is, when you are in the final year, ideally go ahead and write your exams. If you get into the top institutes, then close your eyes and join. It's almost, you will not find a single guy who has an IIM Ahmedabad final admission after graduation and says, hey, I want a 1 year experience in the world. That guy is the only guy, usko mila nahi hai achha college mein. So let's say you get into a lower level tier 2 institute. In such a case, I would then advise, instead of going to a tier 2, pick up a 1 year experience or even 2 years for that matter, and then again try for the top IIMs. That is when it makes sense. Otherwise, absolute fresher also can join. So there is no significant advantage of 1 year experience. Either it is 3+ years experience or start off the earliest you can get into an MBA. As simple as that.
Okay, sir. Thank you. It was really an insightful answer. So,
Amol, I'm missing you. I can't hear you. Amol, your voice is breaking.
Okay, yeah. The types of MBA programs.
Yes. Amol, your voice is broken. Can you please repeat?
Yes, sir. Sure. And another query is, could you please elaborate different types of MBA programs?
So please understand, obviously there are many types of MBA programs, but the most popular ones are the 2 year full-time MBA courses, which are the ones which I would recommend that anybody takes up, anybody with less than 5 years of experience. Any student who has more than 5 years of work experience should look at then a 1 year MBA program, which is called the executive MBA program, like the ISB of India or the PGPX programs in the IIMs themselves. So the two flagship programs which are important in India and abroad are 2 year full-time programs or 1 year full-time programs. There are other programs like online MBA, part-time MBA, other kinds of things. To my mind, it makes almost zero sense to take them up for a simple reason that the value, the corporate, finally, why are you doing it? That somebody gives you value for it, right? The corporates give you value and give you the job for it. If you do a online or a distance learning or a part-time MBA, 99% of the corporates don't value you. Hence, I would not, while they are available, do not do it is what I would say.
Okay, sir. So, sir, another query is that my mathematics is not strong. Then how should I crack CAT exam? Or how may I start preparation?
Okay. This is an important question. And everybody who's asked this question, I'm going to answer this question to you. See, quantitative ability is one section in CAT. 34 questions, if you look at the last 4 years and even the fifth year, this is CAT 2020, the pattern is not going to change. 34 questions are there. 3 marks per question, that is 102 marks. I'm going to give you a very practical answer now. 102 mark ka paper hai. to get a cutoff. See, finally, at the end of the day, if you want to go into IIM Ahmedabad or IIM Calcutta or IIM Lucknow, you need to get a cutoff. You may be good in, let's say, verbal ability, but very pathetic in mathematics, so to say. It is not mathematics, by the way. It is quantitative ability. Mathematics is 11th and 12th level or degree level. This is quant. It's called quantitative aptitude, by the way. Anyway, so you need to get a minimum percentile. Minimum percentile. And what is the minimum percentile? If it's IIM Ahmedabad, it is 70 percentile. Even if it's IIM Lucknow, which is the highest, it is 85 percentile. To get 85 percentile in the CAT exam, out of 102 marks, a student needs less than 30 marks. 30 out of 102. Tum pass ho jao, beta. Pass ho jao, cut off ho jayega. So, ye jo idea hai na, dimaag mein ki bahut difficult hai. Haan, difficult hai jab tumko 100 mark chahiye. Difficult नहीं है जब 40 मार्क चाहिए. So you plan for it. If you are bad, no problems. You plan. You plan to get that 45 marks. Plan to get that 40 marks. Worst case, pick up arithmetic. Pick up geometry. It doesn't require any great intelligence. It requires practice. If you do that, anything can come.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, next.
Yeah. So next question is, I can't decide, but should I go for research or MBA?
Hey, that depends on you, actually. Yeah. Research karne ke liye research bent of mind chahiye. You need to have the inquisitiveness. You need to have the aptitude for research. What does mean by aptitude for research? Two, three things. Ek problem ko bahut hi bariki se dekhna. Every types of angle से देखना, उसके बारे में research करना, patience चाहिए उसके लिए. You need to dig up a lot to get one idea. Meaning, you need to if you are the person who kind of can read a lot to get one point and pick that up and do the same thing. For example, I know of a lot of my friends who are PhDs, who are basically doctorates. एक लाइन लिखने के लिए या एक पैराग्राफ लिखने के लिए दे विल हैव टू कंसल्ट सम 15 बुक्स एंड मे बी 15 चैप्टर्स इन ईच ऑफ द बुक्स टू गेट वन वेरी गुड स्पेसिफिक पैराग्राफ फॉर देयर रिसर्च. आई एम गिविंग यू दैट. दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई इफ नोबडी अंडरस्टैंड्स दिस दैट अ पीएचडी टेक्स यू 5 to 7 इयर्स एंड इट इज दिस मच ऑफ अ थिक बुक एट द एंड ऑफ द डे. So it requires a lift. So are you the person who can do this? Then research kar lo. Agar wo rahi, wo tumhara idea hi nahi hai ki main sala baith hi nahi sakta hu, tum kahe soch hi kahe rahe ho. And I don't even understand this question actually, because then you are completely muddled in your brain of what is research and what is MBA. Research has nothing. I mean, I'm not saying you can't do an MBA with, you can do a management research. But again, the bent of mind is different. If you are that, take up research, my friend. If you are a business guy, if you want to do business, whether it's in the marketing side, finance side, industries, various industries, you like that kind of jobs, then please do MBA. I mean, this question makes no sense according to me. Anybody who's asking me is clearly neither they know MBA nor research in that manner. It's just a random question. Nothing wrong with random questions, but you know, think when you are asking this question. Sriki, hai ek cheez kya?
Okay, sir. Sir, next question is, can you suggest some books for preparation?
See, there are zero books for good. There are hardly any good books for preparation as far as CAT is concerned. GMAT, the official guide, is excellent. But CAT, because of the nature of the exam, it keeps changing every year. And that is the reason why most of the coaching institutes, not just Career Launcher, I can tell you others also, they have to keep on updating this grid. If you look at any of the GRE, GMAT, SAT, LSAT, all these international exams, the type of question, the kind of question, the area of nothing changes. They are very, very standard. Jo 2010 mein tha, 2020 mein bhi wahi hai. But if you look at CAT, it is different. So therefore, while the books that are available are, you know, cat paper books which are available, which you have to buy, I would honestly suggest pick up a good institute like Career Launcher to ensure that the latest books and materials and tests and mocks are available to you if you are really, really serious about preparing for CAT. In a, you know, the average salaries I showed you in IIMs, top IIMs is 20 plus lakhs. The fees there are 20 plus lakhs. So in a course that where you are ready to spend 20 plus lakhs to get a return on investment of 20 plus lakhs, a 30, 40, 50,000 rupees over, you know, for getting into that is a very, very sensible investment to make. Don't try to penny pinch there is my sincere recommendation.
Okay, sir. Sir, next question that we have is that my marks are below average, but I have a great profile. How can I be able to join top business schools?
I gave you that answer. If you have a great profile according to you, you need to first see one of the key things about CAT, GMAT or any exam is the minimum threshold. Once you get the minimum threshold, they will automatically take you into the interview. At the interview, you need to defend yourself why you have less marks in 10th, 12th and degree. How do you define? Because of your profile. Somebody who has excellent marks in 10th, 12th degree and does not have any other parts of a profile, they can say, boss, main toh yahan concentrate kar raha tha. Persons like you who does not have, who do not have a 10th, 12th degree marks can showcase that, look, I was concentrating on building my profile. But in either of the two cases, getting the bare minimum marks, the cutoffs as we call it, in the IIM, in the CAT exam or the other exams is very, very essential. So you can do that. No issues about. One odd institute will not take you because you have a lesser percentile. Don't bother about it. There are tons of institutes will take you.
Okay, sir. Sir, we have one query from Akash Sharma. He says that he met you last year at Jaipur Career Launcher Seminar and he wants to give 2020 CAT exam. So is it right to take night online classes right now?
Yeah. Absolutely. The last one has just begun yesterday or day for yesterday. You should take it up because there's a fastest way for you to learn and start writing your mocks immediately, Akash Sharma. And if you have met me, you will also have my email ID. Please feel free to mail me.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Sir, I think we are now over with the queries for the day.
Sure. Thank you
so much, sir. It was an amazing and a really resourceful session.
All the very best to be with you. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, I would like to say one thing that I personally loved during your session when you explained the key points in profile like progression, innovation, impact, leadership. I really liked that part.
Thank you so much, Amol. All the very best to you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Sure. Thanks, Umang. Thanks, Akriti. Akriti, right? Her name was?
Akriti.
Yeah. Good. Thank you. Good day, guys. Enjoy yourself. Bye.
Yes. Thank you so much for being such a wonderful and patient audience. Please stay tuned in since we have a session today itself at 5 p.m. Our next session, which is scheduled at 5 p.m. today, will be on GMAT exam. Stay tuned in. Thank you so much.